Hi, in this video we are going to have a look at the Dragon Flame Feast event, which is part of the 6-year celebration in King of Avalon. Compared to the other events, I find this one relatively interesting. It is quite different from what we see normally, and it is it has some reasonable rewards, it seems. So basically what you have to do is, it contains some different parts actually, the event, but the main thing is that you have to collect ingredients in various ways, and from those ingredients you can cook meals, and those meals you can subsequently donate, for which your alliance get a certain credits, and once your credits, that opens extra chests, and that gives the possibility to start a special extra event extra stage of the event where you can get extra rewards. I will not get into that now because we are just starting with this event and we don't have enough yet to unlock this next stage, but hopefully I will be able to make a video about it later. So first is ingredients. So you have 4 different meals and a total of 6 different ingredients. The fish you can get with increasing your troop power. The milk with killing monsters. We have the spice by making alliance donation and alliance help. Can get up to 20, and we have egg, which we can get from gathering resources and also harvesting resources in your city. We have honey, which we can get from assaulting barbarian camps, and finally venison, which we get from using gold and speed ups. With everything, I think there is a chance that you get it, not a guarantee. So you can make these 4 different meals, and if you if you don't have I'm not sure where is the option, but there is an option to also here is the exchange. So if you want something specific, you can exchange it. So you can send a request. You say, I offer, for example, spice because I have a lot of them, and I want venison because I don't have any of it. And you can send a request. There is already an exchange rate that might not be necessarily favorable. I didn't realize that yet, so they already find the, or maybe that is just a general, let's see if I do milk. Oh, milk is even 8-1, so spice is relatively, so it is not a one-on-one, which is a bit pity. But okay, this way you could get things that you want. Maybe some of them are quite easy to get, others not. For example, if you have to spend speed ups and gold, you don't have them. If those, yeah, then you have kind of a problem. So that is something to consider as well. Besides that, what is also a good consideration is if you look at, okay, once you make something, you donate it here, and then you can get some rewards. I tried this one, not sure whether that was smart, because that one actually is not that interesting, I would say. And what is a more interesting one in my eyes? Well, they all have some interest, but okay. The first one, let's just go through them here. The nice things is King Lot, but okay, that is not so rare anymore. And Orlando, but I already have my Orlando with 2 stars, and the amount of Orlando that I can get here is not going to get me to 3 stars, so I'm not sure whether I'm going to be very happy with that. Hero weapons, I only have one orders hero weapon so far, and okay, I know we can buy some in the Alliance store, but it's going quite slow, and we actually get enough for one if we can make all 50 times this stew during the event, and the event runs for a week, so that could be quite interesting. And besides that, we get a reasonable amount of glory fragments and tears of ascension as well, so that's quite interesting. This a little bit less interesting because we don't get enough aqua arcana for one whole gemstone, so that's a bit of a pity. But it might still be interesting. I have to check as well how much do I have in my how much gemstone arcana do I have of this aqua? Actually, can I make one, a complete one, if I get all this? So it might be interesting as well. Finally, the crispy honey roast. That seems to me the most interesting, and that is purely because I really want those celestial badges. So if we can complete this, make 50, then we get 55 of those celestial badges, and that is for me quite a lot. Last Kingdom, First Kingdom, we didn't hold on to our own kingdom, so I didn't get anything for those, so that is quite a pity. So this can compensate for that to get these. I don't know yet what the rewards are for the for the next stage, so hopefully that will become clear later, but this is the way it works. So you can let's go back, we can make something, and I'm probably going to try to maybe I should just do that. So for the honey, I have to do barbarian camps, definitely going to do some of that later. And for the venison, use gold, use speed ups. So let's just see how that works. I actually have a lot running. I have some healing speed ups I can use, I have quite a lot of those. So let's say if I do 1 day of healing speed ups, does that offer me anything for this event? Oh, that gives me one venison, not a lot. That would mean a total of 50 days of speed ups if I get one every day, but at least it's something. So let's just, I'm just going to focus on this first, try to see how far I can get. Okay, and some more remarks about this. That was the wrong, I have to cook, of course. And now that I have cooked, I can donate. This also gives more points for this. This counter. Okay, and we can claim our reward here. So what is important is that, so this is a 7-day event, but each time at reset, all your ingredients and your meals that haven't been donated will be reset, if I understand things correctly. So you really have to, at the end of the day, make sure that on the various accounts that you might have, that you can use as much of those ingredients as possible, because the rest will go to waste. Maybe you can make a few trades, maybe you have something more on one account than the other, although could very well be that you have large amounts of the same thing in all your accounts, and in that case you can of course not do much about that. But okay, keep that in mind. So I hope this helps you get started. So increasing troop power, killing monsters, alliance donation, alliance help, gathering resources, harvesting resources, doing barbarian camps, and using gold and speed ups are the ways to get those ingredients, and you can use that exchange that I showed, although there you have some maybe not so favorable rate. We do quite bad with our alliance, but as I said, it was just getting started. I can probably do a bit more, and this is from our event, so I have not done much yet, but we see that some others have been more active, definitely planning to do a bit more. We are in a small, not very active alliance, so it's not so strange that not so many players have played it significantly. Okay, well, that was it for this first part of the event. I hope this, if you haven't figured it out yourself yet, I hope this helps you get started. And hopefully I can make another video soon where I can look at the second part. So basically, yeah, that involves placing a building and the building I've already placed. And after that, we have to start it, but we can only do that once we have reached a certain point on the bar that we just saw with the donation points. Everybody has to send, you have to make sure everybody is online when you start it, because then everybody has to send a send troops to their to that building so they get some extra rewards. Okay, well, that was it. If you have any further information or if you have any questions about this, that's always much appreciated, and thanks for watching this video.